Good morning, Oklahoma. Welcome to Cow-Calf Corner. Fall is here, and this week we're going to take a closer look at evaluating feeds on an actual price per unit of protein, price per unit of energy, as opposed to just looking at that raw price per ton. This week, I priced two different protein supplements at a mill in central Oklahoma. We could buy 38% range cubes at $4.25 a ton. We could buy 20% range cubes at $312 a ton. Knee-jerk reaction, 312 sounds a lot better than 425, but if we think of what we're actually getting, the 760 pounds of crude protein we're purchasing in a ton of those 38% cubes divided back into that 425 purchase price means we're actually paying about 56 cents a pound per unit of protein that we're buying there. If we take those 20% cubes, on an as-fed basis, we're getting 400 pounds of protein. That divided back into that $312 a ton purchase price, we're paying about 78 cents a pound for protein. Now, the 20% cubes are about 8 cents a pound less expensive on a price per energy basis, but we're buying crude protein supplements. So if we actually take a look at this in this fashion, we want to apply this to a situation where we're going to be supplementing cows here for the next few months. Let's take a hypothetical set of 1,300-pound dry cows. They're going to be calving at the end of January. They're a body condition score 5.5 right now. We want to keep them about where they are until calving season. Those cows are going to need 1.84 pounds of protein a day. They're going to need about 13.3 pounds of TDN per day just to maintain weight and condition. Let's say we've got standing dormant native range. We're going to assume that they're going to eat about 25 pounds a day of forage dry matter. That's going to be about 5% crude protein content, 55% TDN. What we find by doing the math from the dry matter intake, the protein, and the energy content of the grass is that we're okay on energy, but we're coming up to about 1.25 pounds of protein they're ingesting from that grass. We've got a deficiency of about 6/10 of a pound a day of crude protein. Now we know supplementing cows with crude protein grazing stand and forage is very effective. In this case, if we relate back to those 38 or 20% range cubes, we actually find a cost, if we meet our protein deficiency with the 20% cubes, of about 47 cents a day. If we do that with the 38% cubes, we're not going to be feeding nearly as many of them. They're more cost effective on a per unit of protein basis. It's going to cost us 33 cents a day per cow. Take the 60 cows, take a look at doing this for 100 days. What does it equate to in terms of potential savings? About $837 of difference that we would use by feeding the 38% cubes as opposed to the 20s. The details in the math are on my next couple Cow-Calf Corner newsletters. So just an idea and a quick example of how important it is when we go to the feed store, don't react to the price per ton or the price per bag. Actually take a look at what we are paying per price of unit of protein or price per unit of energy based on our feeding objective. It's a key to bottom line success and profitability in the cow-calf business. Thanks for joining us on Cow-Calf Corner.